Hey guys, what is up and welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, I am Cath, the creator of Thecontentbug, and I'm here to help you follow your passion by growing your audience online. Now, if you are a website owner, then Google Analytics is extremely important to you. And you may already know that if you are a blogger, that you absolutely need to have Google Analytics. And if you don't have Google Analytics yet, what are you doing? You need to get Google Analytics now. It is very simple to get your website verified on Google Analytics. I actually have a checklist that you can use in the description bar down below if you still need to do that. But in this video, I'm gonna talk about how you can use Google Analytics to your advantage. So I'm gonna go over some of the features that you really need to know so that you can use Google Analytics as a tool to help grow your blog. You can see what's working and what's not working so that you can maximize what is working to continue to grow your blog and make more money and fix the areas that aren't working so that you can have a well-rounded website that's gonna bring you success. So if you're ready to get started, I'm gonna jump over to my computer, we're gonna look at Google Analytics, and I'm gonna walk you through the things that you really need to know.
When you log into Google Analytics, this is the first thing you are going to see is your audience, your overview. Now, you may actually have a home page that may look a little bit different and give you some different information. They have been driving me here recently, but otherwise, if you do not have a home page set up, your typical spot that you're gonna land is an audience and overview. This is the first main page that you need to pay attention to within Google Analytics. Let me explain. This page has everything that you need to know first glance, how your website is performing, and it's automatically going to pull up the last 7 days' time. And this snippet right here is some good information you need to know. Users, how many people are actually on your website? Page views is another important one, which a lot of bloggers go based off of. And page views means the total number of pages viewed. So a lot of people go based off page views, but this is just kind of an overview to see how you did the past week. One of the things that you really need to know is how to change the time, which is right up here. So this, you can change the date. And let's say we wanted to do for the whole month of July. We can look at the whole month of July, see how we're doing. And right now, this is currently bringing up users. That is the first metric that is always going to appear, is users. But you can go ahead and click on this option right here, and you can change it to page views. So if you're curious how your page views are doing, you can go ahead, click on that, look it over, and that's how that goes. Within your audience section, there are a few other things that you could pay attention to if you're interested in where your audience is located. It would be under the geo section. You can check to see what device they're on, so you can see if they're using their laptop or their phone or their iPad. All of that information is going to be within technology. But the next place you really want to go is acquisition. Under acquisition, this is where you're going to find out how people are actually leading to your website. So if you go to acquisition, all traffic, and then you're going to go to source and medium, this is going to show you the exact pages that are leading to your website. Now, I'm still over a month's time right here, but you can see that my number one source of traffic is actually Pinterest, and the second one is Google. So that's extremely important to know, and you can see that there's all these other Pinterest out there from different countries. It's just good to know what strategy is working for you, what's not. I can see that right now, Facebook and Instagram, they're not driving traffic to my blog, but Pinterest and Google are, and that is important to me that I'm getting this organic traffic right here, and that Pinterest is doing well because Pinterest is really my main platform. The next thing you're gonna wanna pay attention to is down here in behavior. This is where you're gonna find out what pages are working the best on your website, what ones have the most traffic, and how they are performing. So if you go to behavior, site content, all pages, this is where you're gonna find out what those pages are. The first thing that's gonna pop up is the URL of the pages. If you wanna look at the page title, if that makes it easier for you, all you're gonna wanna do is click on this page title button right here, and then it's gonna pull up the page title so you know exactly what you are looking at. But the first analytic it's gonna give you is actually the page views, and then you can draw this over across up here. So if you're curious and you just wanna get your page views quick and you don't wanna deal with the audience and switching it, you can just go to behavior, site content, all pages, and your page views will appear right here. And you can see all of these blog posts and pages and see what ones are your most profitable and visited right now. Now, if you are curious about how you can find out what keywords are actually leading to your website,
that is within Google Search Console. So if you want to know more about that, I am shooting a Google Search Console video for next week, so you'll have to stay tuned. But otherwise, I hope this video was helpful. If it was, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel because it really does help to support me. And I will see you guys back here in another video very soon. Bye, guys.